I need to breathe.
Me too.
Breathe. We are joined by two-time Grammy Award nominated, multi-platinum and chart-topping singer-songwriter.
Oh, stop.
No, beautiful don't. Camila Cabello. How are you, girl?
Well, thank you so much for that introduction. I am great. How are you guys?
Oh my God, stop. We're really good. Thank you for asking.
Your new video for Liar is amazing.
Thank you so much.
I can see you doing movies because you play the characters really well. Are you tempted to go into that?
Yeah. I mean, honestly, I love acting. I've been taking a bunch of acting classes and it's just been really fun. I feel like, I mean, I was such a drama geek when I was in middle school, when I was younger. I just loved, I love just like being silly and I love lying. I'm just kidding. I'm kidding. But yeah, I would love to do that.
What happens at acting classes? Because I'm a bit of a performer, but you know, I want to know what's going down. Do you have any lines you want to test out on us? Anything you want to
rehearse? Sure. I mean, you could give, you know what I do? Sometimes it's really fun. Like if you give me a sentence and then you're like, you say all these different emotions. So you will like say it happy, like you'll say
so
it
like,
angry.
For example, like give it to me. Like see how many ways you could say that.
Okay. Well, are you sure you want that one?
Yeah.
Okay. Might be sound a little inappropriate,
but
okay.
Oh, just because it's first song? put it in context, this comes from Fleur's first
okay,
song.
Okay, I was going to say.
This is how Fleur does it.
I do. Give it to me.
That's it. So let's
hear. Oh, that's good. Give it to me.
Great.
Ooh.
Let's hear sad.
Give it to me.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Let's hear you're at Nando's.
Give it to me.
She's going for that black
card.
Yeah,
you really need that. Yeah. You need that. I've actually heard rumors that you are featuring in the remake of Cinderella. Like, this has to be true.
It is true.
Yes!
No!
No way!
Wow.
I know. Yeah. I'm so excited about it.
So you're it's playing really Cinderella?
Cool. Yes, I am.
What can you tell us? Have you seen the script yet?
I have. Yeah. I love it. I mean, it's still in the works. Everything is still in the works, but I'm super pumped about it. I think it's going to be... I mean, I just... want to be a Disney princess so bad.
Yeah.
Oh more God. Than I want anything.
So will you have a glass slipper and everything?
Yeah.
Is that going to be comfortable? I've always thought that was a bad idea for a shoe.
Well, here's the thing. I wear uncomfortable shoes every day. It might as well be a glass one and
Preach.
Might as well be a Disney princess.
Preach.
I've always thought as well, that's a system that could go wrong because I've got a feeling a lot of people have the same size feet. You know, if you're a size 3, you're a size 3.
Oh, yeah,
you know
totally,
I mean?
Totally.
That's all it requires to become a princess.
Hilarious.
You're in.
That's true.
Greg's in.
Well, hopefully I'm the right size.
Camila, I want to know, X Factor this year, they're doing an All-Stars version. And as a fellow
wow.
X Factor alumni, would you go back? Would you ever do it?
I don't know. I mean, it might be fun. I actually think I would do it. X Factor, like, so funny. It brings up, like, two completely different opposite emotions in me. Mm-hmm. Like, there's, like, one emotion that's like, oh, my God, that was so much adrenaline. That was so fun. That was, like, so challenging and incredible. Mm-hmm. And then there's like the other part that's like, I was terrified though.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So yeah, I think it would be cool though, because I think that's where I really first kind of came out of my shell, you know, was X Factor.
I mean, you should ask that question back to Fleur, because obviously you've both done the show.
Yeah. What about you?
I definitely relate to everything you just said.
Yeah, totally.
It's just conflicting emotions. You're like, oh my gosh, the happiest time, but most also nerve-wracking time.
Exactly. But also I was literally felt like everything was life or death.
Yes.
Every second of the day. Yeah, it's honestly an insane amount of adrenaline, that show. It's like so much adrenaline.
Yeah, it really is.
Talking emotions, I've got a feeling I know how you'll feel about this question, because you must have seen the little girl on Ellen doing the duet with her dad.
Yeah,
have you seen that?
Yeah,
how did that
so
make
sweet.
You feel?
Oh my God, it's so sweet. It's so sweet. I mean, that little girl was just so adorable. It just made me smile. I mean, it was just the cutest thing I've ever seen.
Oh, it was very cute.
So your single is called Liar, which we're loving. Now, obvious question, but we want to know, what's the last lie you told?
Ooh.
It can be a little white one, or we'd love a big one though.
Let's see. The last lie I've told.
It better not have been about Cinderella.
I mean, well, I guess like, I think that, you know, I think everybody tells little white lies. Like, let's say, you know, like yesterday I was having kind of like a weird day. And if somebody's like, how are you? And you're like, great.
Yes. I
think everybody does that.
Mm-hmm. Totally.
Just because you don't have enough time or you don't know the person well enough to be like,
I just tell people the truth now.
That's actually great.
I'm not great.
I'm not going to try doing that.
Yeah, try it. They don't like it. You do sometimes get coffee though.
Yeah, totally.
At Starbucks when I've done that.
Not great.
For my birthday, babe, I wanted to do a duet with Shawn Mendes, but he was kind of busy. I don't know why.
I mean, it's not like he, you know.
Yeah. So I hate to tell you this, but I made my own version and I sort of cut you out of it. And
you know what? That's okay.
Yeah, I want to know what you think. Like, honestly, Camila, do you think I'm better than Shawn? Shall we hear it? Are you ready?
Yeah, let's hear it.
I love it when you call me señorita. I wish I could pretend I didn't need you, but every touch is so
much. Yours is like the ASMR version of the song.
I'm going to take that as a very big compliment.
It's not bad. Like, I'm not saying it in a bad way. It's just different. It's just different. Yours is the ASMR slightly off-key version of the song.
I'm just kidding.
Just kidding. No, you were actually on key. You were just maybe a little flat at times, but it's okay. So am I sometimes.
We've all been there. We've all been there.
Will you play it to Shawn, please, and ask him what he thinks?
Oh, yeah, totally. For sure.
Thank you.
There's one of those little white
lies. That's one of those lies. Guys, ask me that question again. That's the last lie I told.
We spoke on the show before about dating someone that you work with. So how's that going for you? Have you ever had any arguments in the workplace, you know, over the desk?
Yeah, totally. I mean, when we did Over the Desk, when we did Señorita, it was definitely like a lot of like disagreeing. That's always happened though. Like anytime we work together, it's kind of fun.
How did it feel performing at the VMAs with Shawn? Because everyone was chanting for you to kiss. Like BB was getting involved.
I know.
Did you? Was it awkward or did you just go with it? It felt funny.
I mean, we didn't see him.
So,
I didn't even know it. I didn't even know like people were reacting like that till after. But it was really fun. It was like, I was less nervous than I thought I would be.
I felt like we were just like flies on the wall watching you two alone. Yeah. It was just so passionate.
Is it nice how everyone stands your relationship? Or are you like, guys, leave us alone?
No, I honestly don't even like, I feel like we're just pretty normal about it. Like, I just don't even kind of register anybody else, you know, but like him and I.
Such goals. I hit my microphone. I'm so in love with that.
The video of you and Shawn kissing badly is so funny. I want to know, what's your worst kissing story that you've ever had?
Oh my God, my worst kissing story. That's so funny. Well, my first kiss, I almost fainted.
What?
Wow.
I just got really nervous and I felt like I was going to black out.
Where were you?
I was like in the person's house.
Oh, that was a very hilarious media moment for you there.
Yeah. And I was on a beanbag and he like leaned in to kiss me and then like we were kissing. I was like, oh my God, kissing. And then I almost blacked out, but I was fine. Wow. I didn't fully faint, but I felt like I was going to.
I feel like that's a good review. Like for the guy, if that was a TripAdvisor. Like,
but it didn't really have anything to do with him. I was just like, oh my God. I was just like, I don't know. I was just like, oh my God, like kissing. Whoa.
Yeah, I'm doing it.
It's happening.
Especially because my
first kiss was so late. I had my first kiss at 16.
Ooh.
So there was like so much buildup. I was like, oh my God. Everybody's like, when's your first kiss? And I was like, I haven't had it yet. And so then I was like, whoa, this is the big shebang. This is what they're talking about. This is it.
I love it. That's amazing. Thank you so much for talking to us today.
I have one more question for you, actually.
Ooh. Yeah, tell me.
I lived for your photo shoot with your mom in the airport that time.
Thank you. Yes. We gotta recreate it.
Yeah, when is the next photo shoot with Mama?
I think maybe next time at the airport.
Right, it's just gonna be an airport only thing.
I'll do it. I forgot. But now that you mention it, that was a good old time. So I will do that again.
And do you travel a lot together with your mom?
Yeah, I do. She's with me all the time.
Fleur's mom gives her a lot of inspiration on this feature we've got called Mum Day Motivation. Mm-hmm. Does your
That's
mom
so cool.
ever give you any kind of inspo, what she told you?
Every day.
Oh.
I think it just depends on like what I'm going through. You know, I think that just like, I think growing up, you just, especially in, you know, this career, you're just finding yourself all the time. And there's just highs and lows all the time. And I think I just learn a lot from her, especially during my lows, you know, because I don't know. I think the last thing she told me was probably just to, like, be, I don't know. I'm trying to narrow it down. But I think just how important attitude is, like how important your mindset is for things, and how important, like, the dialogue in your mind is, like the way you speak to yourself in your head.
Yeah.
You know, when you're having a bad day, not beating yourself up about it. Oh, she always tells me to not dwell on the past. That's been like a big lesson for me.
I love that.
You know what I mean?
Does anyone else feel like breaking into a verse of Mama by the Spice Girls?
Mama.
I thought that was just me. Thank God.
Mama. Any chance to audition
ASMR.
Again?
It's ASMR singing.
Back in the room.
Yay.
He's back.
Oh, you've been amazing. Thanks
for coming on the show. So fun. Thank you, guys.
Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.
Yeah.
Love your mom. Wake up. Let's go. It's Radio Breakfast. It's Radio Breakfast. With Fleur East, Greg and James. It's Radio.